So I'm actually going to come over here and I'm going to save this, and I'm going to do while grid, call this while grid, and we're going to make this very simple. We're going to give a white stroke. Let's make the stroke weight 2 pixels so they're a little bit easier to see. And then we know we want to draw a line from x, 0 to x, comma height. And if we just set x for the moment at 50, let's see where that line is. We have our one vertical line. So now we were saying, okay, if I have one vertical line, I could do x equals x plus 50 and draw that line again. And now I would have two vertical lines. So why not? This is the code that needs to happen over and over again. So why not say, let's just do that code, let's just do that code as long as x is less than the width. Let's run that. And now we've got that. You can see all of our lines going nicely across the screen. And hey, if we did this with x, why not just do it with y? And while y is less than height, we want to draw a line from what? 0 comma y to width comma y and increment y by 50. Ah, what's wrong? The field component dot y is not visible. That's what it says down at the bottom. Oy vey. What's happening? I have forgotten. I'm using a variable, but I forgot to declare and initialize it. So I just need to make sure I add my variable y up top. And then we come down here. And I'm going to just scroll down so we can see the draw function and run it. And what do we see? We have x going across, y going down. We have our beautiful grid. Interestingly enough, what is this? There's all these numbers, x equals 50. Well, let's start x at 0, y at 0. Why? There's this number 50 here. Well, that should give us an idea. Why don't I have a variable called spacing and have that be equal to 50? X equals x plus spacing, and then y equals y plus spacing. This should give us the same result. It does, but now I have something exciting I can do. What if I were to say spacing equals spacing plus random, negative 2, some random number between negative 2 and 2. Now we can see the spacing in between the lines is changing randomly. So I hesitate to offer that this is any sort of interesting or exciting visual effect, but it's showing you how we can use a loop to draw many lines across the screen, and then we can vary how we're doing that by using random, using the mouse. You hopefully will come up with something creative. You could change the colors.